Ladies and gentlemen, this Wednesday night, 7 o'clock in the Omni here in Atlanta, Starrcade 89 Future Shock. And I want to bring on the team now that many feel will win the Iron Team Division. Let's hear it for the Road Warriors, ladies and gentlemen, Hawk and Animal. This coming Wednesday night in the Iron Team Division, it's going to be physical, fellas.
We don't stop Jim Ross. There's a lot going on in the NWA. Sting, Muda, Flair, Funk, Luger, the Four Horsemen back. The Road Warriors are here. You got the Steiners do Starrcade, which separates the NWA from everybody else. We have real athletes here, and if you don't like it, we don't care. Now, Doom, Skyscrapers, and Wednesday night, you're going to pay Starrcade Future Shock. We're going to prove to everybody who the Iron Men really are. Tell them, brother.
Well, you know, me and Animal Jim, we don't carry health insurance. You want to know why? We don't need to. You see, we all take risks in life. A parachutist takes a risk of his parachute not opening. What a rush. A man that swims with sharks could get bit. What a rush. What a rush. We live life on the edge. Sometimes we fall over the edge and get back up on it. That's the difference between us and everybody else. You see, we truly do snack on danger and dine on death. And a lot of people are gonna find out when they get in the ring with us that it's better to be dead and not make money than try to make money against us, because we are sick individuals. This here is the truth. If you don't like it, we don't care, because we're not changing for anything or anybody. We're just gonna continue what we do best, and everybody knows what that is: beating people up. And we're gonna continue for a long time.
Ladies and gentlemen, Wednesday night at Starrcade, Road Warriors will meet the Steiners, the Road Warriors meet the Skyscrapers, and the Legion of Doom meet Doom. Wednesday night at 7 at Starrcade. More on that in the hour.
Ladies and gentlemen, in the ring from Trenton, Georgia, he weighs in at 225 pounds, Pat Rose. His tag team partner is from Delray Beach, Florida. He weighs in at 210 pounds, Sean Regal. Opponents making their way into the ring area from the City of Sunshine, weighing in at a combined total weight of 477 pounds, Johnny Ace and Shane Douglas, the Dynamic Dude.
Well, they are not Bruce Wayne and Dick Grayson, but they got a $10,000 cashier's check, irrevocable, a Mama Cornette bag money.
You know, we usually don't disagree, Jim Ross, but you seem to think that this is quite funny because the aggressive vendetta against Jimmy Cornette. This is what's wrong with the youth of America today. They're steep. We're teaching the youth of America to admire two feet. These kids are nothing but street poodles.
Well, I'll tell you something. Turn about is fair play. Remember, Cornette led them along the primrose path and then lowered the boom on them.
What Jimmy Cornette did was teach them a lesson. Never trust anybody in life. Someday I'll tell you the trust me story about me and my father.
All right, Pat Rose starting out against Shane Douglas of the Dynamic Dudes. Man, they ought to have some fun partying this week.
They certainly should with Cornette's money, and I bet they spend it on something useless things like food, shelter, and clothing.
Yeah. Right, skateboard, concert tickets, movies. These are good kids. I'll bet a lot of it go to charity. You don't know the truth about it. You got Pat Rose over, trying to head scissor, but took him on over with the legs anyway.
The last time I saw a move like that, Jim Ross, is when I was in Memphis and I walked by your hotel and the curtain wasn't shut.
Yeah, right. Well, I don't remember that, fans. That must have been somebody else. It might have been Lance Russell or some other announcer. Uh-oh, here comes Johnny right over the top.
Good move. Good move. Jim Ross, I want to say one thing. I listened to the Road Warriors interview. If confidence has anything to do winning Wednesday night in the Omni, the Iron Team division, nobody has a chance against the Road Warriors.
You know, I have asked him how they're going to wrestle the Steiners. And, man, you talk about a look like it's one of those ex-wife looks when the check's late. I mean, it isn't very pleasant.
Certainly
they
was.
Don't want to talk about wrestling the Steiners. They got something on their mind. But one thing the Steiners have that the Road Warriors want, obviously, is the World Tag Team Championship. And if they beat them at Starrcade, they're going to be right in line for an opportunity at the earliest convenience. Rose Bush with a clothesline. Johnny quick to get to the advantage. Nice inside cradle there, but Johnny's in the ropes. Referee called for the break. Tag made. Here comes Sean Regal in.
You know, the dudes, whether you like them or not, basically, they have the basic technique of wrestling down as a tag team. I admire their tag team works. I don't admire them.
Nice move there. You don't like their attitude. You don't like them spending time with the kids and signing autographs.
Well, I think they're wasting a lot of time doing things like that.
These young fans really, I think they have their feelings drastically hurt if the dudes turn their backs on them, and they will not do that, I'll tell you. These kids are young. They identify with the young fans.
One thing they need to do is they need to get an offensive mounted right now. They're getting...
standing vertical suplex. Nice move. Tag team move there. And they are...
big mistake. When you have a man down and you have him beat, you cover him. This is the difference between the dudes and the Midnight Express. Cornette doesn't allow that because both those guys are captains. Both of them know that winning is everything.
Another team move right off the rope. Dynamic dudes. Tagging in and out very quickly here.
They're taking a page out of Cornette's book. Cornette showed them how to tag in and out. Good move. And if they don't cover this guy now, they're making a big mistake.
The wipeout did it. The dudes have won it.
Colors of the match, Johnny Ace and Shane Douglas, the
dudes. Oh, look, fans, in the seats. What happened here last week, Norman and Teddy Long had a little altercation, but look at this move.
Jim, they set him up. It's called the wipeout, and that's what it does. It wipes out. Face to your neck, snap, crackle, and pop.
Here's what happened last week with Norman and Teddy Long.
Teddy Long just got a manhandle Norman out of the ring. We got a match in the ring.
Come on, get out of here.
And he's got the teddy bear. Theodore just got pushed on his own keister.
Who does Norman think he is?
Well, he's a human being. He's got to be treated like one. Long up on his back with a match in the ring. Long topples off the shoulders of Norman.
That's a teddy bear 2 weeks ago Dr. Death gave Norman. We saw him at the Clash of Champions. Norman reciprocated and gave Doc a teddy bear.
Norman's now got the key. He's not going to be afraid of Teddy Long anymore. He's got the key and the teddy bear. And the crowd here loves it.
Cuban Assassin, listen, I've got something that I want you to take care of for me. Now, Norman the Lunatic is driving me crazy. So what I want to do is have you next week right here on national television to get rid of Norman. And I'm going to pay you $350, and it's mostly American money.
You know, $350 don't mean nothing around here, but in my country, it means a lot. Norman, I'm coming after you. I'm going to rip you apart, Norman the Lunatic. I'm coming after you next week.
And that's right.